There came a Dutchman to this land, an immigrant, perhaps refugee. He left his homeland for the south, bought some land and filled his mouth with beer and cigarettes, so worry-free. Then he met this younger girl, long-lost passions did unfurl. A nurse from farming parents, would they expect adherence to the norms of this community? There was a gap in age, you see. She 19 years, him 33. I'm not sure those ages. But the number's right.
We get to the stage where the Lumen Street caretaking cartel is set up. So, 10 years ago, just as I say, he had the good sense to hire me. And 6 months later, I realised that if I had any good sense, then I'd stay here for 9.5 years until I retire, and which I did. Gus is that lovely mixture of hard work, humour, a little bit of stubbornness, but a big heart and a lot of care. I say that there are about three times in that 10 years where Gus has really pissed me off. And a lot more times when I pissed Gus off. But I think I've written down here, 115,273 times when I felt he's supported, respected, and valued. That's not a bad bloody scorecard. A couple of things. Gus's his technical ability is higher than mine, but a lot lower than a registered builder. So there's a registered builder. Gus is here on here. So sometimes we get some jobs, and we laugh at our lack of finesse. Challenging jobs. When we complete them, Gus says, "Oh, we should go into business together," as in the repair business or the unblocking grain business or the whatever, you know. There's a bit of graffiti. There's a legitimate graffiti in behind a wallboard somewhere over there. I can't remember exactly where, but it says remodeled by Kate and Corbett Limited. If you find it, let us know. Gus loves a catastrophe. I do recall coming in here one school holidays with a list of jobs to do in my mind, and then walking here, and of course this place is absolutely flooded, and I'm heart sick. Oh. Ring Gus. Gus comes over and says, "Oh, goody, goody." 2 hours later, flushing and mopping. Gus is still positive. I'm well over it, you know, but he's very keen and very young. Where do I go to after that? You probably know that Gus is going to be travelling. Gus is the main reason why we're going to be doing some travelling in Europe next month, and we're looking forward to catching up with Gus in Europe and looking at his Tūranga Waiwai and seeing where he is and meeting with some of his family over there. So we're really looking forward to that. You know, Gus is enjoys a lot of fun, and he's made both staff rooms, Tamata and H&I, a great place to be. A few things he's helped us with: the 40th anniversary ABBA tribute, of course the Caretakers Beatles medley, and I'm particularly remember the YMCA, the spoof that was put on here for Marilyn's farewell. Mm-hmm. Gus has always been keen to get stuck in and lighten the place up in that regard, which is lovely. There's a lot more I could say, but I'm going to leave it there. You know, he's a caring person. He cares for kids, for staff, for the schools, for the environment, for his workers. He's been a tremendous asset. And we also know that he has done far more, well and above what we would expect anyone to do as a caretaker in their role. We've been blessed to have him in our community and have him as a friend and a colleague. So thank you, Gus. Right, we've got the end of the song coming.
So it's bye bye to this man we call Gus. Though we all know that you hate all this fuss, but for these 17 years you have touched all of us with your caring kindness and love. And that I know.
Before Gus gets into his words and opens up his